nice different pictures now because, well, all that long time after. I will.
Yesterday, at the rehearsal yesterday, Jeff said, "All right, Nate, you're in charge." I said, "You know, those are the first and last time you'll ever hear Jeff say those words."
Wow.
You relinquished the good luck stick.
I know.
You got the rack.
My mom called, "Make sure you take the ski rack off, just in case, because you haven't registered in New Jersey yet. They might ticket you."
Right, if they noticed him going, you know, back and forth to any, you know, well, anywhere, it's all the time. You know, they'd pick him out. Oh, they do need him.
So, that,
so
I took it
that
off?
That day I had told him that you have to take it off.
They did do some raking.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody did. Okay.
How you doing?
I'm good. See ya.
Hey.
Wow, how you doing, man?
Very good.
Very good. Look at my camera. Start with you.
When he suddenly thought of it. He said, okay, but it'll be windy because it's outside.
Move in.
Everyone have a phone on?
Oh, you got it.
To not be scalded.
hope everyone can hear me. We're outside and we might be competing with a few other noises, but I'll try to project as best I can. Welcome everyone to beautiful Cold State Park on an absolutely beautiful fall day. On this extremely special fall day, in fact, special for everyone here, but particularly special for Jeff and Jade, as they take the next in a long series of steps of commitment to each other. My name is Nate. It's my great honor and pleasure to preside over the marriage of Jeff and Jade, Jeff, my cousin, and both my very dear friends. I know you all will join me in celebrating their love for each other and sharing in one of the most memorable and happy days of their lives. Tears are good. It's been a little while. Jeff, Jade, today you're here, surrounded by your friends and family, who have congregated to share this joyous day with you. We're here to pledge our love and support for you, both as individuals and as a couple, at the same time you pledge your love and support for each other. Marriage is a large and bold step for those who choose to take it. You have turned toward each other in search of a more fulfilling life than you might achieve individually. The playwright Anton Chekhov once mused, "Perhaps the feelings that we experience when we are in love represent a normal state. Being in love shows a person who he or she should be." Every day, Jeff and Jade, your love and marriage will continuously show you who you should be. Joined as one in marriage, you'll become closer than you have ever been. The pathways of your lives converge today and will not diverge from this day forward. Your union will still, however, remain comprised of two individuals who draw strength, courage, and wisdom from that union, but still seek to make their own individual contributions to the world. Your partners in life, striving to be the most that you can be, and also to bring out the best in each other. At the end of the ceremony, you'll be officially married. But the special relationship that really is the essence of marriage won't begin then. It has already begun when you chose to embrace the joys and pleasures of life together and to face its anxieties and tensions together. This ceremony can't create marriage. I certainly can't create your marriage. The state can't create marriage. Only you, Jeff, and you, Jade, can marry yourselves and each other with a loving commitment that brings about compassion, consideration, and respect. You've chosen to marry before all of us here, and we, in turn, have chosen to bear witness to your commitment. We wish you happiness in marriage. We wish you wisdom and strength to overcome obstacles. We wish for you to live every day mindful of the vows that you say today. We wish you prosperity and good health, and we wish you perseverance when those things don't come easily. And finally, we wish that at the ends of your lives, you can say to one another, "Because you have loved me, you have given me faith in myself. And because I have seen the good in you, you have given me faith in humanity." Now we have a reading by Nicole DeCambra. Two readings, fine.
They chose each other, they don't need to choose one. It counts. The first one is called A Lovely Love Story, and it's about dinosaurs. They're both dinosaur peeps. The fierce dinosaur was trapped inside his cage of ice. Although it was cold, he was happy there. It was, after all, his cage. Then along came the lovely other dinosaur. dinosaur melted the dinosaur's cage with kind words and loving thoughts. "I like this dinosaur," thought the lovely other dinosaur. "Although he is fierce, he is also tender, and he is funny. He is also quite clever, although I will not tell him this right away." "I like this lovely other dinosaur," thought the dinosaur. "She is beautiful, and she is different, and she smells so nice. She is also a free spirit, which is a quality I much admire in a dinosaur. But he can be so distant and so peculiar at times," thought the lovely other dinosaur. "He is also overly fond of things. Are all dinosaurs so overly fond with things?" "But her mind skips from here to there so quickly," thought the dinosaur. "She is also uncommonly keen on shopping." "Dinosaurs so uncommonly keen on shopping?" "I will forgive his peculiarity and his concern for things," thought the lovely other dinosaur, "for they are part of what makes him a richly charactered individual." "I will forgive her skipping mind and her fondness of shopping," thought the dinosaur, "for she fills our life with beautiful thoughts and wonderful surprises. Besides, I am not keen on shopping either." Now that the dinosaur and the lovely other dinosaur are old, look at them, not them. Together they stand on the hill, telling each other stories and feeling the warmth of the sun on their backs. And that, my friends, is how it is with love. Let us all be dinosaurs and lovely other dinosaurs together, for the sun is warm and the world is a beautiful place. Next. I love you, not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am
today. And share with family and friends a day to look back on happy times and forward to even happier times ahead. A day to laugh and love and dream.
I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the foolish, weak things that you can't help dimly seeing there, and for drawing out into the light all the beautiful belonging that no one else had looked quite far enough to find. I love you because you are helping me to make of the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple, out of the works of my everyday, not a reproach, but a song. I love you because you have done more than any creed could have done to make me good, and more than any fate could have done to make me happy. You've done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You've done it by being yourself. I'm going to try not to go away.
According to the program, this is where I'm supposed to introduce Jeff and Jade. Hopefully, you all know at least one of them, unless you're a few hours late for the wedding that was here earlier today, in which case, sorry. Jeff, as I said before, is my cousin. And our relationship has gone through a lot of different kind of phases in 25 years, I guess, since you've known me. We've always been able to get along, though, for at least a day. And you know what? Yes, we've only been here one day. But and I think our mothers thought we were insane when we decided to live together in Boston. You know, a prospect of a whole year, when that would have been pretty unthinkable before. But it worked out. It was great. And I think mostly that's because Jeff finally admitted that there isn't a single video game in the world that I can't whoop him. And you know that's just the way it is. But really, Jeff and I have known each other for a long time, and since high school we've gotten closer and closer. And he's about as bright and kind a person as you'll ever meet in this world, and I really do count him among my dearest friends as well as family. So. That's Jeff. And then there's Jade. You know, I first met Jade at in Glens Falls at a family Christmas gathering. And I think my first thoughts were the same as all of Jeff's friends and family when they first meet Jade, is that he's kind of trying to play a little out of his league. That's obviously not the case. It's been a long time, so obviously Jeff's doing all right. And I got to know her, especially when we lived in Boston too, and mostly we played Mario Kart together and bonded that way. But I now know Jade to be a witty and genuine and absolutely wonderful person, who I'm also proud to call one of my dear friends. And as a couple, they've got a lot in common. You know, they were in pet band. They both like kittens. but that's kind of the point. Is that their real strength as a couple is in complementing each other's personalities. And anyone that spent time with them together knows that they go about things a little bit differently. But they always seem to come to an accord, and it really is what I think is a really endearing harmony. And I think they're great together. All right, now we've come to the audience participation section of the program. First, if the parents of the bride and groom would please stand up. A wedding is first and foremost about the union of two people. But in addition to Jeff and Jade becoming joined in marriage, their families will also merge. And as one, provide love, strength, and support to the newly created family. Cheryl and Joseph, do you accept Jeff into your family? Bonnie and Bruce, do you accept Jade into your family? You may sit down. Does everyone here, all the family and friends gathered, pledge your love and support for Jeff and Jade, both as individuals and as one new family?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
All right.
Thanks, Gib.
All right. The vows you exchange do not have any magical or prophetic powers. They are simply and profoundly a reflection of the reality that exists in your hearts and minds, a firm, deep, and powerful commitment to each other.
Oh.
Sorry. All right, Jade, repeat after me. Jeff, you are my heart. You are the tears of joyful laughter, the warmth of a hug, the excitement of a first kiss. Today I give you my hand in marriage and promise to stand by you today and all the days of our lives. I promise to smile with you in the warmth of good fortune and cry with you in cold times of heartache. I promise to love you unfailing when love is simple and when it is tiring. I promise to look to you, to see the good in people, to be inspired, and to know the meaning of infallible love. I know that without you, my life is only half complete. I promise to keep you in my heart, my mind, and my soul, today and for the rest of our journey, throughout life, no matter where it takes us. Now it's your turn. Jade, you are my best friend.
Jade, you are my best friend.
And my true love.
And my true love.
You are my ray of sunshine on a cloudy day. And my shoulder to lean on when I can't stand on my own.
And my shoulder to lean on when I can't stand on my own.
Today I give you my hand in marriage.
Today I give you my hand in marriage.
And promise to stand by you.
And promise to stand by you.
Today and all the days of our lives.
Today and all the days of our lives.
I promise to smile with you.
I promise to smile with you.
In the warmth of good fortune.
In the warmth of good fortune.
And cry with you.
And cry with you.
In cold times of heartache.
In cold times of heartache.
I promise to love you unfailing.
I promise to love you unfailing.
When love is simple.
When love is simple.
And when it is tiring.
And when it is tiring.
I promise to look to you.
I promise to look to you.
To see the good in people.
To see the good in people.
To be inspired.
To be inspired.
And to know the meaning of infallible love.
To know the meaning of infallible love.
I know that without you.
I know that without you.
My life is only half complete.
My life is only half complete.
I promise to keep you.
I promise to keep you.
In my heart.
In my heart.
My mind.
My mind.
And my soul.
And my soul.
Today and for the rest of our journey throughout life.
Today and for the rest of our journey throughout life.
No matter where it takes us.
No matter where it takes us.
For thousands of years, rings have been exchanged as a symbol of marriage by myriad cultures. Though objects, they nevertheless perfectly capture the full range of ceremonial, communal, and symbolic aspects of marriage. Timelessness, wholeness, undying love, continuous renewal, and eternity. May I have the rings? Jade, take this ring.
Jade, take this ring.
As a symbol of our unending love.
As a symbol of our unending love.
Wear it to remember that which brought us together.
Wear it to remember that which brought us together.
Joined us this day.
Joined us this day.
And gives hope to our future.
And gives hope to our future.
Jeff, take this ring.
Jeff.
As a symbol of our unending love. Wear it to remember that which brought us together. Wear it to remember that which brought us together, joined us this day, and gives hope to our future. After today, you will have taken a big step in your lives, individually and as a couple. Through good times, you will be each other's celebrant, and through bad times, you will be each other's strength. You will revel in each other's successes and mourn each other's failures. Marriage charges you to take responsibility for making each other feel safe and to give the highest priority to providing the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection needs and deserves. Remember this through the inevitable frustration and difficulty that confronts us all from time to time. And always recall the symbolism of the ring on your hand. Come back around to what you know to be right, that you are voluntarily and joyfully and beautifully and inextricably joined together, and that your union is the best thing that either of you have. Finally, always remember to take a moment to step back and marvel at the wonder that is your relationship, and as husband and wife, to be each other's reason. With that, I pronounce you married, and you may kiss to conclude the ceremony. And with that,
sorry.
Would you read the program?
You're not in the way. You're never in the way, Mom.
Oh, you
I could do anything without that.
But that's later.
Oh, okay.
That's for Kim.
Oh, hi, Kim.
And Jeff and Jade.
Hi, Kim. Can you sing your happy birthday song for me? I forget how it goes.
But also thinking that I'm glad that California imagine if we don't have another drum major coming into the family who can count and step up, we'll take us all off the right foot, if you know what I mean. Jeff, Mike, and myself, and now Jade. She was, so she's in there. But really, I'm so happy that Jeff and Jade are finally getting married.
Yeah.
And I'm very lucky to have brothers who have such good taste in people that I would want to have as my big sisters. And my wardrobe, as Jade just mentioned. But I'm so lucky to have somebody who is now their big sister, who I've never had big sisters. So I'm very lucky, and I love you very much, and I hope that wish you guys all the best, and I know that you'll be happy and for a long, long time. Okay. And I'd also like to tell Jeff, my big brother, that he needs a seatbelt because he's been for a ride after me.
All right, Susan, you can give the mic to Mike. And Mike, I will only caution you that there are people over 30 here, so I do know you have a lot to get even for. Although I do have to say Jeff was quite good. Quite good. But I'm sure you're up to equaling the abuse he gave you. Ladies and gentlemen, your best man, Mike Kropp.
You're going to need him. Okay, thank you for joining us again. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Jeff's younger brother, Mike. And on behalf of the bride and groom, I would like to thank you all for joining us and helping make today a most memorable occasion. And to Jeff and Jade, I would also like to thank you guys for allowing us to be a part of it.
Yeah.
And speaking of being a part of it, when Jeff asked me to be his best man, the only thing that went through my mind is he out of his after the speech he gave at my wedding. I thought so. But I was honored and I gladly accepted this opportunity to embarrass the heck out of him. Growing up with Jeff wasn't always as easy as most of you might think. Sibling rivalry was rampant. For example, one time when Jeff came home from college, he thought it would be funny to lock me in the bathroom while I was taking a shower.
What?
Well, I got out of there a lot faster than he thought I could, and I went looking for him. I found him in the computer room, cowering in a computer chair, and the only thing he could muster was tactical error. Another particularly difficult part of having Jeff as a brother is that teachers would compare me to him. Jeff didn't have to study in school to get good grades, and unlike myself. But when he did study, his grades were even better. And that's probably what landed him at Northeastern University. That's how he met Jade, thankfully not for us. And that's what eventually got him into Microsoft. So Jeff, I guess being a geek finally paid off. And as a kid, I never got to do anything first, because Jeff had already done it. He'd already done it, including playing with my new toys. He told me he was helping me by reading the directions and putting the stickers on, but I knew he really just wanted to play with it first. However, because he did everything first, he was my best source of information. Like when I was 13 and starting to get a little bit chubby, I asked my older, wiser brother if I was starting to get fat, to which he replied to his younger, more impressionable brother, "No, you're not fat. That is a storage tank for an overactive sex drive." for the 10% of his life. The first 10%, for obvious reasons, was his salary at Microsoft. Jeff, I'm still waiting for that. The other 10% was 10% of his engagement. Because he did his at the in Paris, at the Eiffel Tower, during the light show, I told him I was going to ask Robin, my beautiful wife, if she would marry me at the Eiffel Tower at the mini golf course while my friends held up flashlights and sparklers. But she said yes. And there was more to the Robin, I told you could edit my speech, not delete it. And I asked.
Now you know why I didn't ask you to stand for the toast.
Now I've got it. It's just a few things. Wait a minute. This is my speech.
It's not your part.
Growing up, Jeff was a lot of things to me over the years. He was my computer consultant when I wanted a new computer for going to college with. He was my best friend, even though I didn't always admit it or like it. And when I didn't have the money for a piece of equipment for my guitar that I wanted, he was the bank that loaned me $125 to get it. He was also the loan officer that charged me 25% a week. I swear I'll get you that money. Okay. You know, and through all this, I can't forget Jaden this whole thing. First to get engaged and last to get married, I think, was the quote that she used. Jaden, you've been a part of her family for the last few years, but now it's official. And legal. Some of you might be thinking there's some similarities between yourselves and Jeff and Jade, and I've come up with a way to determine whether or not you might be Jeff and Jade. If you pick your cats on kitty play dates, if you have a leash and harness for your cat, you might be Jeff and Jade. And folks, I've seen it firsthand, and I can honestly say Jeff wears the pants in the family. He just has to wait for Jay to tell him which pair to put on. If you show pictures of your cats to your friends, like they're your kids, you might be Jeff and Jay. If you are having a custody battle with your significant other over your cats, you also might be Jeff and Jay. And if you take a pre-wedding honeymoon to Europe, you might be Jeff and Jade. And Jeff, since you already took the honeymoon, I'm guessing you're not going to Maine for a couple weeks. So tonight, just make sure the stickers are in the right place. I could say a whole lot more about my brother after all 26 odd years. Definitely enough ammo, but the look I'm getting from him right now definitely tells me it would be a tactical error. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in raising a glass to Jeff and Jade. Jeff and Jade. Jeff and Jade. Trying to take time each day to do something small to remind each other that you still love each other as much as you do today. And no matter how many miles are between the two of you, keep each other close in your hearts and in your souls. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeff and Jade.
Beach Boys, God only knows. No, but we need you, all four of you out there now, and a long.
No one else answered.
I know.
Thank you.
If I shut up, I might even be able to get in a second one. So, that being said, I'll say the PCD was a presentation in association with the Productions and the World Network of Virtual Music Incorporated, which is solely responsible for its content. I gave the Cisco for the electronics. Say, bye-bye, be good, be careful, can't do that. Be careful, thanks for listening, God bless. The Beatles, in my life.